Dear students, I am Shiva, Faculty of Physics. In the last session, we discussed this concept for 9th standard, that is force on dielectric slab between the plates of capacitor when the capacitor plates are maintained at constant potential. But at that time, we discussed one point, what is the nature of that force, that is variable or constant, and that force is responsible some oscillatory motion, that is simple harmonic or not. Now, in order to confirm that point, now we can find out the expression for the force acting on the dielectric slab. So, first of all, assume we have introduced the x length of the dielectric between the plates of capacitor. Since x length of the dielectric is introduced between the plates of capacitor, that remaining free length, at some time t what we are seeing, total length L, out of that L, x length now filled by this dielectric, now dielectric constant K. Now, what is that remaining length? Remaining length is L minus X. What is the remaining length? Remaining length is L minus X. Now, here one little question to you. How many capacitors here we are seeing? So, please pause the screen 1 minute and think yourself. Now, let us answer. So here actually it is completely only one capacitor, but you can observe carefully, this is the combination of two capacitors that is connected in parallel. So here you can say this plate is connected to positive terminal, this plate is connected to negative terminal. Suppose I am assuming this negative terminal is lying at the potential 0, this positive terminal is lying at the potential V. Now potential difference till V minus 0, V only. If this is V, this is also V. If this is 0, this is also 0. Nothing but at the time of insertion of this dielectric, this one lies at V potential, this one lies at 0 potential. Means this part at V, this part also at V, this part also lies at 0, remain this L minus X part also lies at 0. Means we can visualize these are two capacitors. These are two capacitors that are connected in parallel. Suppose, say this dielectric constant K having that length X you are seeing currently inside. Now, regarding to this part now, say this capacitance is C1. Regarding to this part, this L minus X length of the gap between the plates of capacitor is filled with air, na? Say this part now what? C2. This part, X length part we are assuming as having the capacitance C1. This L minus X length of the part we are assuming having the capacitance C2. Okay. Now, this force, what type of force? This is electrostatic force exerted by the free charges on the individual charges. That's why electrostatic force is conservative force. That's why here what we can write, F is equal to minus du by dx. Again, you can observe carefully, here u indicates the total potential energy stored between the plates of capacitor. Again, here we can analyze carefully, whenever we are introducing the dielectric slab, it experiences force in the leftward direction. At that time there what will happen, charge on the plates are increases. Whenever charge increases, capacitance also increases. Whenever capacitance increases, at that time energy stored between the plates of capacitor also increases. Nothing but energy is the something we can expect, maybe function of it, suppose. That's why here what we can think, energy also continuously changing. What type of energy? Electrostatic potential energy stored in the form of electric field between the plates of capacitor. That energy also changing. That's why here what we can write, this U, electrostatic potential energy. So this one we can write, suppose half QV, again U is equal to half CV square, again U is equal to Q square by 2c. Now these are the three expressions that we have for electrostatic potential energy. Now observe which form now we can use carefully. Please pass the screen to me and think yourself which expression for us useful in order to substitute here. Okay, now see the answer. So here QB is charged on the plates of capacitor, but this charge on the plates of capacitor, we don't know how it was changing continuously while inserting the dielectric slab, even V constant. Okay, even V constant, still we don't know how the charge is changing on the plates of capacitor. That's why we are unable to use this expression. Again, you can see here, charge on the plates of capacitor changing. This is free charge or unitary charge? This is free charge. This free charge is continuously changing, as well as this capacitance also continuously changing. That's why here we are unable to use this expression also. Okay? Now, here exactly we can use this expression, half CV square. So C indicates capacitance that is changing, V indicates the potential difference between the plates that is constant. That's why now we can use this expression. Substitute this value of U here, then what we can write? F is equal to minus d by dx of half CV square. V constant, 2 constant, then take it out. What we can write? Minus V square by 2 d by dx of C. Okay? C indicates capacitance of the capacitor. In the previous situation there, I told na, this parallel plate capacitor, we can think combination of two capacitors that are connected in parallel. That's why, now resultant capacitance what for us? Resultant capacitance C is equal to sum of the two inducible capacitors with capacitances C1 and C2. C1 for dielectric of length x, C2 is the that dielectric is you are seeing as A of length L minus X. Now what is C1? So in generally the formula for C is epsilon naught A by D if there is no dielectric. K epsilon naught A by D if you have dielectric. Now C1 we are seeing some dielectric of K constant. That's why what we can write here? K epsilon naught. What is area of this part? This is X. Okay? This is L. X into L. Okay? This is L. This is X. So, totally what is the area? The area now Lx by. What is the distance between these two plates? That is D. So, K epsilon naught into Lx by D plus C2. C2 for what? C2 for this one. Where you are seeing the dielectric in the form of A of length part L minus X. That's why the part we can write again. Now the dielectric here A, for A what is the value of K? K is 1 for A. That's why what we can write epsilon naught into. So what is the area? This is L minus X. This is L. This is L minus X. This is L. That's why what we can write here again. L minus X into L by. What is the separation? The separation now here D. Okay? So again you can observe this expression carefully. Here you are seeing some terms common. Epsilon naught L by D common. Now take it out. What you can write? Epsilon naught L by D into Kx plus L minus X. Okay, again what we can write? Epsilon naught L by D into L plus K minus 1 into X. So this is the equivalent capacitance C we found in terms of X. Now substitute this value of C in terms of X in this expression. Now what we can write again? F is equal to minus V square by 2 into d by dx of this expression epsilon naught L by D into L plus K minus 1 into Yeah, so this is the expression. Now we can do that further calculation here. So there, what for us again, F is equal to, so F is equal to minus V square by 2 into, so the, here clearly we are seeing now, this is epsilon naught L by D also constant, take it out. Epsilon naught L by D into, so take the derivative inducibly, d by dx of L plus d by dx of k minus 1 into x. Okay, so again we can write f is equal to minus v square by 2 into epsilon naught L by d. L is what? L is length of the square plate. That's why here what we can write, this part of length is constant, L is constant, this derivative will become 0. Again here x constant, x is variable. Why x is the introducing length of dielectric, this is variable. But k minus 1 we can say constant. That's why here what we can write, k minus 1 into d by dx of x. So again it will become d by dx of x value 1. That's why here what we can write, minus v square into epsilon naught L into k minus 1 divided by 2d. So this is the expression for the force acting on this dielectric square. In which direction? In the leftward direction. So here clearly we are seeing this force is constant in nature. Why? This force is independent of the length of the dielectric. This force is independent of the length of the dielectric. Nothing but whatever may be the length of the dielectric, this force is always constant in nature. Again this minus sign indicates this force is attractive in nature. The electrostatic force acting on this dielectric slab due to these free charges always start to attract this dielectric slab. That's why this force is constant in nature as well as this force is attractive in nature. One more important point, this force you are not seeing in this form. F is not directly proportional to minus x. F is directly not proportional to minus x. That's why this is not SHM. Okay, this is not a simple harmonic motion. This is just what type of motion? This is just as an example of what type of motion? Oscillatory motion. That's why finally we can conclude what are the points here. Whenever you are introducing the dielectric slab between the plates of the capacitor at constant potential, the force acting on the dielectric slab is constant and it is attractive in nature as well as it is responsible for oscillatory motion. But that oscillatory motion is not simple harmonic. Okay students, I hope you understood this session well. In the next video, we will meet with one more important concept.